السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على عبد الله ورسوله محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. We praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We send blessings and salutations upon Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his household, his companions. May Allah bless them, bless every one of us, grant goodness to the entire ummah. May Allah make us resolve our matters, our disputes. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bring the ummah together. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us that togetherness in the most unique way. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala cleanse our hearts for us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from those who make an effort to clean our hearts, and may He favor us in this beautiful season. My brothers, my sisters, the supplications we make to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the dua that we make to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we must be serious about the dua. There is no point in calling out to Allah to give you something and you're not making an effort. You need to make an effort as well to try and achieve what you're asking for. So when you ask for goodness, you try and do goodness. When you ask for protection from evil, you try your best to abstain from evil. You don't just walk towards sin and say, "Oh Allah, protect me from sin," but you're walking towards it. So we were continuing from the previous episode. We mentioned the hadith of Anas bin Malik radiallahu anhu. I did not yet complete that hadith, but I'm quickly recapping it. He says the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam used to say, "Allahumma inni a'udhu bika min al-ajzi wal-kasali wal-jubni wal-harami wa a'udhu bika min adhab al-qabri wa a'udhu bika min fitnati al-mahya wal-mamat." Oh Allah, I seek your protection from inability or disability. I seek your protection from laziness. I seek your protection from cowardice. I seek your protection from old age. I seek your protection from the punishment of the grave. And I seek your protection, O Allah, from the trials and tribulations of life and death. And the hadith ends there. It is muttafaqun alayh. Hadith of Anas bin Malik. Who was this Anas bin Malik radiallahu anhu? He was a khadim. He was a servant of the Prophet, peace be upon him. And he served the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam for 10 whole years. And the point that comes to my mind when I think of this beautiful individual, as he was a young boy, he grew up, he was one of the last to die or to pass away from the Sahaba radiallahu anhum, and he lived for a long, long time, mashallah. Anas bin Malik radiallahu anhu, he says, "I served the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam for 10 whole years. Not once did the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam say a bad word to me. Not once did he say oof to me. Not once did he say, 'Why did you do this?' Not once. I served him for 10 years and he actually spoke to me with utmost respect. He helped me do what was my task, what I was tasked to do. He helped me do it. He did not get angry with me. He did not get upset." I remember telling some brothers and even some sisters, my brothers, my sisters, how many of us, with those who work for us, with the helping hands at home and anywhere else, we get upset and angry every day. We swear and shout. We treat them in such a belittling fashion that it is embarrassing to call ourselves followers of this great example, who the servant himself is saying never did he do that. Never did he say a bad word. He always helped me. He respected me. He was smiling. He didn't even say oof to me. And I served him for 10 whole years. With us, every 10 minutes, there's a bad word that comes out. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive us. We still call ourselves followers of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Isn't that embarrassing? So my brothers and sisters, Anas bin Malik radiallahu anhu says that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to respect me big time. Subhanallah. May Allah make us from among those who are inspired to respect those whom we work with, who work with us, for us, and subhanallah, all those whom we work for as well. That having been said, these young people told me, "Well, that was the Prophet, peace be upon him. I'm not a prophet." Astaghfirullah. Come on. That's a very bad way of looking at things. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was sent to us in order for us to try and follow his example. وما أرسلنا من رسول إلا ليطاع بإذن الله. We have never sent a messenger except that he should be followed, except in order that he should be followed by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So follow that example. And then they say, well, the people working for us were not Anas bin Malik. And maybe if Anas bin Malik was working for us, radiallahu anh, then maybe we would have been the same. He must have been such a good worker. Those are cheap excuses. Don't say that. We are not the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and the people working with us, for us, whatever, they are not Anas bin Malik radiallahu anh, but the example fits. We need to be more careful about how we speak. You want the mercy of Allah, have mercy on others. If you want your answer, the answer of your dua and your supplication, have mercy on people. But imagine you are calling out to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and you've just harmed all those around you. What do you expect to come in your direction?